Good morning, everyone. Well, good afternoon, wherever the day finds you. We're road tripping today to Coffs Harbour. Got everything packed, just about ready to leave. So, yeah, not sure how boring this blog's going to be, but probably just be travelling most of the day. Didn't even brush my hair. But yeah, we'll see what today brings. Hey everyone, just cruising along. We just passed Clyde Bucker truck stop. So yeah, probably, I don't know, a couple of hours to go, I guess, an hour and a half maybe. So yeah, cruising along, doing good. Maxi's punching along. Maybe haven't even used half a tank yet. So yeah, going good. Not sure how far behind Dad is. So yeah, he's going to Tammy's and we're only going to Wagulga, so we'll probably be in the pool by the time he goes past. I'm sure if he has any dramas, he'll ring us. So yeah, cruising along. Not much to see. There's Abby in the back. Ferrells. So yeah, haven't been up this way for a while, so yeah, not much has changed. Highways are good. Bit of road works, but it's all good. Spent many a night in this spot fishing. Used to catch heaps of bream, flathead. Yeah, loved it here. That jetty wasn't there. The boat ramp was, but the jetty wasn't. This is North Beach or Milestone. My old fishing hole, all those fish smashing bread.
Do they eat like anything else but bread?
Oh, bread, prawns. Prawns are always a big winner.
So is the trick following a bit of bread then casting your line?
Yeah. If you threw all that bread in and threw a hook in with bread on it, that'd smash that as well.
No, I'd put a hook in your prawn because I'd go for that over.
Yeah, but they eat bread and prawns.
They'd rather prawns.
And oysters.
I can smell prawns now. Can you smell?
Yeah, the oysters on the... That's what you can smell is the oysters.
Well, remember when I sliced my whole foot open with oysters?
Mm.
How I ran across to try and...
Hey.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I did not wait to step straight into the water. That's a good idea.
Yeah, father coming in here, Cates.
Oh, we should get your camera and, like, put it in the water so we can see through. Right. With the salt water, was this fresh or salt?
No, it's fair salt. Got them sneaking in here.
What is it?
See, you can see they're black on their tail.
Oh, yeah. You can actually see through the water, too.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, look at this black one here. I wonder what sort of fish that is. Yeah, it looks like a little whiting there. Yeah, I'll show you where I used to live in a minute. Oh, pelican. There. There. There's a few whiting in there as well. A few whiting. Bream. Caves, check out this bunny picking on the little ones. See? You'll see them, they hunt the littler ones. Yeah, small fish can get in there.
Look how many fish there is.
There. Yeah.
My phone won't be able to see through that. I don't think. No.
Hey, look at them all here.
Oh, that's mad. Oh, Dad, if you look down, all you can see is just a little fish.
Yeah.
See,
there's a brim like, down there, bigger one.
Look at that. There's just like, there's probably like 6,000 fish.
Hey.
Boy, Mum. That's insane.
Put them up there, in the shallows.
Yeah. You see, if you look straight down, you can see all of that. Whoa, Dad, look at all them little ones.
Yeah. The little fish are probably loving it in there because the big fish can't get to them.
Yeah. Imagine when they get a bit bigger,
there's going to be
like so many
here. Just taking the kids on the scenic tour through the Coffs Rainforest, out near the rally go-kart track. It says 1 kilometre up here, there's a roundabout. Like, seriously? Have a go at the place. There you go, you had it for yourself. A kilometre ahead, take the third exit onto the roundabout, whatever it was. A bit of water. Crazy. Well, 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 what do we have here? The old Repton Milestone and Coffs. boost. Back onto the highway. Bloody hell, 10 seconds ago, like in the middle of Never Never. It's the old school I used to go to, Coffs. Blue building down there. Used to go there for, that was one of my classrooms in year five, I think. Yeah, and I had mass up on that two-story part. Yeah, one of them rooms, the air coats, I think it was that one there, that one, was the one where we put eggs on the fan.
Yeah.
And like, nearly the last day of school. Old high school, old
big school,
old Jetty Jail, it used to be called.
Looks like it.
Yeah, it just goes all the way up here. Alright, and it used to suck because sometimes you'd have a maths class up here and a science would be right down the other end, and you only had like 5 minutes to get there.
Yeah, you used to run class.
Yeah, you used to have to bloody run the class.
What did you get up to at that school?
No, not much. Yeah, that's it. Nah, I was actually pretty good in high school. Until I went to Rome Terrace.
I'm not.
Yeah, that's how big it is. It goes all the way around. Alright. And then it goes all the way down here. Fucking. Goes all the way down here.
Is that bigger than Kobe's high school?
Yeah.
Alright, that's it all the way down there. That's it there, that's the bottom of it there. Yeah, spent many a day snorkeling in that creek. That's the, just the air caves. I don't know what I told you. About me getting electrocuted in a barbecue. Yep. You know, when barbecues first come out, like them electric ones you used to put money in, let's try a super caravan park. Huh. Changed all this. It was when they first brought out the electric barbecues and you had to put money in.
Yeah.
People would put like 20 cents in and me and one of my mates thought it'd be a great idea to bloody chisel a brick out.
Well, that's something.
And pinch the money. Well, the cable that makes it electric, right, is bloody like super powerful, and it's not insulated. And I got booted, probably probably from the barbecue, probably about the length of this car away from the barbecue. Yeah. Oh yeah, melted my fingers together. That was a stupid thing. Just to run across that field, across that oval, and in line with that building. Basically straight across where that fence is, where I used to live. These flats here, that's where I used to live, and where that white car is, not the first white car, the other one, that was our flat. Right where that window is, not where the balcony is, the one under the balcony.
Okay. Oh.
Right, that was Nana Pop's room, and then mine and Tammy's room was behind that. And where that car is at the side there, used to be a carport, and that's where you used to go out the gate, straight into the shopping centre car park. Yeah. And that block of units wasn't there then. That used to be an empty paddock, so, and that was the driveway there.
Yeah.
That I come unstuck on and ripped a chunk out of my elbow.
It looks like
yeah, just there. Yeah, that building never used to be there. So that was like a shortcut from the hotel room or motel room, whatever you want to call it. The next 3 days. Behind this wall's toilet and shower and whatever. Our fridge, all our snacks. Just laying back, relaxing. Took about 4.5 hours to get here, I suppose, but we went through the old town that I used to live in, showed the kids and spent a bit of time there, and we sort of went out through the bush trail that you would have seen. The motel that we had booked, we ended up ditching that one and coming to this one. This one's heaps nicer, pretty much same money, and the other one's pool was out of action, so not that we're going to be spending a lot of time at the pool, but it's good to know that it's there if we want to use it. So we've already been for a swim and it was absolutely freezing. So I guess you expect that this time of year, but anyway. Had a bit of a play with the waterproof camera that we bought, like the little GoPro looking thing, like just a cheap version of that. So yeah, that seems to work all right. So haven't really sort of caught up with anyone yet, so we'll make some phone calls later tonight and sort of see where everyone's at and work out a game plan for tomorrow. So tomorrow's going to be pretty hectic. Not sure how much I'm going to be able to blog, but doing sort of photos and videos for my sister for a wedding. So yeah, we're gonna have Kobe's gonna have the video camera, I'm gonna have my camera, might even throw Kylie on my mobile with my little gimbal thing, see sort of what we can catch her, try to catch as much as we can for my sister on a special day. So yeah, just gonna rest up tonight and take it easy. Back's drilling me at the moment, so yeah, it's only what is it, about 6 o'clock, 6:30, whatever. So I'll finish up the blog here, just so I can just chill out and sort of relax a bit, ready for tomorrow. So hope you're having a good day and hope you're having a good weekend. So stay true, stay positive. Cheers. Good morning, everyone, or good afternoon, wherever the day finds you. We got this hair today. It's crazy. There's Eb. Just sitting back in the motel room at Woolgoolga. Oh, I don't know. Just sort of chilling out for a bit for the wedding, the Savo. So probably from about, I don't know, 1 o'clock, whatever, sort of everything sort of starts to get ramp up. So I think the wedding's at 4, but I've got to go and do photos and stuff like that earlier. So yeah, beautiful day outside, as you can see. Yeah, beautiful day out there. It's already 17 degrees at 9 o'clock in the morning. So yeah, it looks like it's going to be a good day. This is the place where we're staying. Beautiful pool. Bullhead. Yeah, you wish. This place where we're staying is absolutely beautiful. Like, beautiful pool. You're allowed to have pets here too. So, yeah, really good. Shut up, babe. So yeah, we're gonna just chill out for a few hours this morning, and then sort of start getting ready around lunchtime and head up to where Tammy is and take some photos. And yeah, so from about lunchtime on, it'll be pretty hectic, I'd say. But once it'll be pretty full on after lunch. But so I thought I'd get in now and get some videos done. Kids are about to jump in the pool with a camera, so yeah. Just sitting back chilling, watching a few videos on YouTube. Probably doing a lot less than the bride and groom today. Just sort of kicking back and relaxing. Went for a swim earlier in the Bullfed. Caves. Went for a swim earlier. Got some funny footage on the on my waterproof camera. So yeah, I'll gonna do a like a holiday video once I get home, or I might do it over the weekend maybe if I feel like it. But we're having a good day, nice and relaxing. So like I said earlier, from about 1 o'clock onwards, we'll sort of be pretty flat out, suited up and all that. So looking forward to seeing everyone. Not exactly sure who my sister's invited, so it's not a huge wedding, but just sort of the important people, I guess. I was chatting to the bloke that owns this place earlier today, and he's had it for a couple of years and spent about $150,000, he said, since he bought it. New sign and sorted the pool out and a lot of landscape and stuff. And so yeah, it's a real nice place here. Definitely recommend it. And pet friendly as well, which is good. So yeah. We're at the reception. Wedding's done and dusted, so we're at the reception now. Tammy and Peter on their way, so let the party begin. Hey everyone, just got home from sister's wedding, from the reception. Absolutely buggered. Back's absolutely drilling me. I don't know whether it feels better sitting down or standing up. That's how sore it is. Anyway, it was a good day. Beautiful ceremony. Something a little bit different to what most people are used to seeing. It was like a traditional ceremony and then a tying of the ribbon ceremony. So just something a bit different. That's always good. And then, went to the reception and, everything was good there. Took a heap of photos and just sorting them out now, putting them onto the computer so my sister can have a bit of a sneak peek at them before I start editing them. Kylie's in there coughing up. She's been pretty good most of the day, so it's catching up with her now. I think it's caught up with all of us. So we've come home a little bit early. The reception was sort of meant to finish at about 11. We ended up bailing at 10. I just couldn't do it anymore. Plus there was probably only a quarter of the people left, so we'd cut the cake and danced and all that type of stuff. So my sister danced with Peter and with me dad, or with our dad. It was a good day. Feeling it now, but it was worth it. That's life. Wish them all the best. And I've still got to do my little bit for their wedding video. I haven't done it yet, so I might do that tomorrow. So it won't be till I get home that I'll start edit the wedding video anyway. So I'll probably do that tomorrow sometime before we sort of do too much else. So with that said, I'll sign off for the day. I think we've all had enough. I'm just about to upload these photos, grab a hot shower, smash some painkillers, and then head off to bed. So I'll catch you tomorrow. Stay true. Cheers. Stay positive.
Cheers.
Good morning, everyone, or good afternoon, wherever the day finds you. Just sitting out the front of Woolworths at Wagulgari. Kylie's just grabbing a few things, and had a great night last night at the wedding. I'm still feeling a bit sore, and just went up to where Tammy and Pete stayed last night. They had a barbecue for breakfast or brunch, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, a bit of a catch up for everyone while everyone was still in town. So that was good. It's raining today, typical sort of Coffs Harbour weather. We're just going to grab a few things at Woolworths, head back to the motel, probably have a quick shower, warm up a bit, and then we're heading up to Bruxner Park Lookout. So hopefully we can get some nice photos from up there. The weather's not great, but yeah, you can't do much about that. Go up there and suss out this new pier thing that they've got, that's sort of built out off the hill up there. I'll probably get some footage of that so people can check it out. Got invited to a bonfire tonight at Tammy and Pete's house, so they'll be back home tonight. Yeah, so there's a bit of grog left over, and sort of a bit of a chance for everyone to catch up before everyone heads home. Not sure sort of if we'll end up there or not. Kylie might sort of choose to sort of stay back and stay out of the night air and sort of rest herself, because this flu's really knocking her about, and the cough that she's got. So that's fair enough. We'll just see what this afternoon brings. My back's sort of pretty sore again, so not sure if we'll head up there with Savo or not. Not sure, but we'll see what happens. See how I feel after this. See how I go after we go up and have a look at this lookout. Just back at the motel for a quick pit stop. Uploading some photos and videos off the little waterproof camera. I'll change the battery over as well, just so the kids can use it later if they want to. The other camera is still good at the moment, just waiting for the computer to upload these photos and videos, and I'll get on to editing or saving them at least. just up here at the Bruxner Park lookout. Looks out over Coffs Harbour. Used to always come up here as a kid, having barbecues. Beautiful spot.
Come on. One day none of these trees will be here, I don't think.
Ah, oh, this is a national park and reserve.
So is there like animals in there?
Yep.
What type?
Goannas and koalas and...
Is that a goanna?
Go for an anchor. Can't imagine trying to pull that one back up.
Do they used to use some of that?
Yeah. Here. Them beaches there used to be good to swim at.
Yeah. Any sharks?
Oh, there'd be sharks, but there's no waves. So as a kid, it was really good.
Well, there's little waves.
Yeah.
It's pretty much like that dog beach, like
foreshore. There used to be a good barbecue spot along there we used to always go to. It's sort of like a foreshore, that's what we used to call it.
There's little waves coming, but not much.
Yeah.
Maybe on like the wooden board on.
Just going for a walk out on the jetty at Coffs. Spent a bit of time here when I was a kid. Used to jump off this jetty, go down that deep that you didn't know which way it was up and down. Never told mum and dad, of course, they would have killed me. But yeah, spent many a day here. Bird Island. Name says why. Mutton birds breed there, live there, nest there, whatever. Charge their batteries. Kobe's talking about the little windmill that's on this boat. It charges their batteries on board. It's the Coffs Co-op. Oops, wrong way. Thank you.
Yeah.
Did it used to just drop off?
Yep.
What made them put them there?
I don't know. Stop people from jumping, I suppose. Just gives them another platform to jump off.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
How deep?
Oh, I don't know how deep it was. These two won't bring submarines and tie them up here.
So that means probably like 500 meters.
Oh, I don't know. Just the drop off the jetty alone was enough. Looks like Coffs is in for some normal Coffs Harbour weather. Clouds all around us. Out to sea.